Wait, little kitty. Before you drink that rainwater, make sure you know how it's formed.
How?
Well, that is what I'm here to explain. Hey friends, so in today's episode, let us have a microscopic look at the rainwater and answer a thirst-quenching question. How are rain droplets formed? Zoom in! Water! The reason behind our existence and one of the most crucial elements all living beings need to survive, grow, and stay hydrated. And the best part is, Mother Nature has provided it for us for free in the form of rain that falls from the sky through a process called the water cycle. The water cycle explains how Earth's water is always in movement and is constantly changing states from liquid to vapor to ice and back again. And if you are not aware of it yet, then do check our video on the same topic. The link is in the description below. Although the water cycle has been working for billions of years, and most of us are aware of the fact that how crucial it is for the creation of rain clouds. However, when it comes to the formation of raindrops, there is more to it than meets the eye. Yes, my dear friends, raindrops are not always as crystal clear as they appear. Somewhere inside of every raindrop is a tiny impurity consisting a touch of salt, a speck of soot, a grain of clay that's crucial to the raindrop's existence. And believe it or not, without these impurities, there would be no rain. Confused? Let me clear the water for you. You see, water requires a non-gaseous surface to make the transition from vapor to a liquid through a process called condensation. That's because when the water is in the form of vapor, every molecule moves so fast in random directions that they find it difficult to align perfectly to form bonds and transform into liquid. So, when the microscopic dirt particles like dust on the Earth's surface get blown high into the atmosphere and bump into these zigzagging molecules, the vapor molecules find it much easier to condense around these particles called cloud condensation nuclei. So basically, it means to form a cloud with lots of raindrops, we need lots of these nuclei. And fortunately, we have gazillions of these particles floating in the atmosphere in the form of soot, dust, pollen, mushroom spores, and even bacteria with a name, Pseudomonas syringae. Yes, my dear friends, some experts believe that these bacteria have evolved into perfect cloud condensation nuclei to form a raindrop around them to help the droplets drop down on the ground. And here is the thing. Raindrops don't look like teardrops, although they have been artistically presented this way for ages. However, the common raindrop is actually shaped more like a hamburger bun. In fact, the smallest droplets start as spheres, but on the way down, these tiny drops bump into each other to form a bigger sphere. And as these larger drops have more surface for air to collide with, they get flat from the bottom. And once they reach around the size of 5 to 6 millimeters, they transform from bun-shaped to parachute-shaped, just to get bigger and bigger until it bursts apart into smaller drops. And that, my friends, is a journey of a raindrop falling on your head. Trivia time! Did you know not all raindrops are made of water? Yes, rain also consists of sulfuric acid or methane, which can also be found on other planets in the solar system. Speaking of acid rains, please check our video on this topic by clicking on the link given in the description below. Hope you learned something new today. Until next time, it's me, Dr. Binocs, zooming out. Never mind.